back in the 1950s, most people aren't aware of it, but there was a scientific storm in America all through the late 50s about this thing out there in space, because the astronomers were all watching it, and that was back when they weren't afraid to talk about it. It was in the science magazines. I mean, I had a subscription to, like, Popular Science, and hell, it was on the front cover of the magazine one day in, like, 1961. And I was really excited when I saw it, because here's this giant red planet on the horizon of the California coast, and a humongous tidal wave coming in towards the coast. And having grew up in the mountains of the Sierras, and this thing in the magazine, it said this tidal wave coming in was going to be at least 3 miles high. And I went and showed it to everybody in the house, and they laughed, and they said, "Look, it says right here, there's nothing to worry about. It won't be here for another 50 years. Hey, guess what? That 50 years has came and gone. And this baby's out there in the sky. They've been watching it. I watched it. And I could tell you, this thing has got so much trash coming around it. You know how we live in a solar system? We've got 9 planets and a big sun. This right. thing has got 7 planets and its own sun. The years as it went by and we watched it, it got bigger and bigger and bigger. And then finally, about 08, we could see this thing like it was across the street. And we could see that it was a blazing hot ball of fire giving out sparkles of red iron oxide dust for thousands of miles in every direction. And you could see the planet circulating it. Now, I'll tell you one thing that I really am nervous about. I think this thing's got a planet like ours circling it. This is its own solar system. We're about to have a solar system come through the middle of our solar system. This can't be good. But unfortunately, it looks as though that's what's going to happen. We were looking at asteroids right close to this thing. There's asteroids that are floating around right near the that are orbiting the main sun itself. These things appear to be about 500 miles across. This thing looks like a giant red teardrop-shaped dust cloud, and you can see once if you're able to see it up close like we did, you can see every speck out there. Now, these CIA people that I know say that we're not going to be that close to it when it goes past us. They're saying that in order to attain breakaway speed, when it comes up around the backside of the sun, its speed will at least double, possibly more, which will put it here earlier than everybody is saying it will, and that this thing will probably be about 20 million miles from us when it crosses in front of us. And then as soon as it flips us upside down, we're going to go into its debris field. These CIA guys told me that this pole shift will probably happen from start to finish in around 28 minutes. That doesn't give you a lot of warning. When you see that thing out there in the sky, you're going to have to run as fast as you can to your underground facility.
Y'all, that is the sun right there. Oh my God. That looks crazy. Wow.
When we see it in full view, you're going to know your ass has been had. When we see it in full view, you're going to know your ass has been had. When we see it in full view, you're gonna know your ass has been had.